Monday, December 19th. Time's flying by, isn't it? I just did an earthquake report this morning. When I looked, it was like 44 in the past 24 hours. Now I just looked and it's 12:46 and we're down to 42 in the last 24 hours. So, you know, they can go down or they could rise up really quick. That was just in America. Whatever you see in America, double that in the world, okay? If it's 40 here, say you might as well say 80 to 90 with what's going on in the world. I'm looking for the big explosion to happen here. The other morning when I told you, also look in my description box. I'm going to provide the video link to where you're going to see orbs flying around all over the place. And then you got to remember in the Bible where it says we are in a spiritual battle. The Holy Spirit dwelling within us. Okay, so we have to be careful of the things that we accept, of making sure that they're not an abomination to God. Okay, because then the Holy Spirit will leave you. If you love what's evil in this world, I'm going to read some scripts to it and hear it in a little bit. But you can't accept what's an abomination to God. God didn't create man and woman to be doing what we're doing today. Now today, I mean, you got men with men, women with women, and it's an abomination. Those that accept it, the Holy Spirit won't dwell with you, okay? It's just a fact, okay? I don't hate any of these people that are living this way. It's an abomination, and they're gonna perish for it. They will perish for it. I don't candy coat nothing here because it's a very serious thing that's getting ready to happen. I don't wish to see anybody go through that, but it's still gonna happen because the Word of God says it's gonna happen. I've got new people here constantly on this channel that are prescribing to it. And, you know, you can see that angel blowing the trumpet above my head. Now, at the end of that trumpet, you see the white horse and the bathtub. All right. That's where the Word of God says we, if it wasn't for what Jesus did, we were bought for a price, okay? So therefore, we should glorify God, okay? Because it's by Jesus' blood that we are redeemed back to the Father. So everything that we do, we should honor Him and try to do things pleasing to Him, okay? Not of this world, because those that love this world are an enemy of God, okay? Remember, He said the devil's the ruler in this world here. Okay, because they were cast down out of heaven, down here onto the earth. And He said, woe to the inhabitants of the earth. And, you know, everybody knows the devil's a liar, deceiver, and a destroyer. And if you ever looked at your place where you live in any town or whatever, look at how the streets and the city's designed. It looks just like a spider's web, like a web. You know, that's exactly the way the devil is. Things are designed to traps. That's why we have laws upon laws. And it's constantly making more money. Today, man, if you want a bright future, become a prison guard. You know, that's exactly the way it's heading. We're just getting ready to be destroyed. But you guys, we need to be focused 100% on Jesus Christ, okay? The Word of God says, if you love what's in this world, you're going to lose your life. You're an enemy of God. You can't love what's in the world and Him. You just can't. Jesus says you'll hate one and you'll love the other. And I've had lots of dreams and visions. The Lord has provided me to see a lot of things in this world. That's why when you see those orbs in the link in the description box, where you're going to see these things flying all around me. That's because He made it to where I could see a lot of things. I've seen demonic spirits touching stuff in the coolers and the grocery stores. I've seen them even doing this in the restaurants where they'd spit their tongue out really fast like that, like a serpent. They do this really fast, okay? And I don't like to have to show that stuff to you guys. I really don't, but I'm just trying to tell you what's really going on. I've seen these demons moving around here just like normal people would. They're everywhere. There's lots of them. Actually, there's more than there ever was before, because the devil knows his time's short. There's so many of them out here. These things can jump in you. If you love what's an abomination to God, these things can jump in you. Because if the Holy Spirit's not in you, then you've got nothing to stand on. Nothing. Only by the grace of the Lord do we have the blood that protects us, okay? And they're still going to try to get at you with the stinking thinking. It's happening to a lot of people right now. You know, I've even made comments to people about having what it was that I seen and what I knew what it was. But a lot of people don't want to hear it. They don't want to believe it. Nobody even wants to believe that they're going to go through anything here in America. Listen, if people over there have been having their heads cut off, millions of Christians been killed over there already, where Jesus Christ started his ministry, and you think it's going to be a cushy ride here until it's time for you to go, you're in for a rude awakening, okay? The wrath, yeah, some of us will be spared the wrath, the hour that's coming upon the whole world. Yes, we will be spared that. But if you think that you won't experience anything, most people are asleep right now because they haven't even been paying attention to what's going on. They don't, you know, the news ain't even showing it no more. They were a couple of years ago when it first got started, when that one news reporter from America, CNN, I think, or CBS, was over there, man. He made a live speech moments before they cut his head off on live television. They showed it when it first happened. Actually, it was on the internet, and they took it down where people couldn't see it anymore after that. They cut the poor man's head right off, and today, people in America, they're fine. Their barbecue grills are working just fine, and they're getting their everything they hearts desired here. They already forgot about that poor man, okay? Not to mention all our other brothers and sisters over there that have already been brutally murdered, beheaded, raped. Even little children, man. They went into playgrounds and put little children's heads on sticks in the playground. You know, and people here go, oh, I didn't hear about that. I don't know about that. I didn't hear nothing about that. That's because they're not paying attention. You know, and then they're thinking, oh, the 7 years tribulation ain't even started yet. Oh, it started. We're well into it. The Bible warned it, said, don't let these days come upon you unaware. Boy, I mean, it really surprises me how so many people do not know this. They've literally, see, and that's why we got a lot of these people mocking, scoffing, causing trouble on these stations here. They don't want you to be focusing on the truth. Instead, they want to make me look bad. They want to make the truth look bad. Okay? Because that's what they do. That's what they do. Okay? Here we go. It's St. Luke, chapter 21, verse 34 through 36. It says, and take heed to yourselves, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and cares of this life, which you see here in America. That's exactly what it is. And so that day come upon you unaware. Most people here are unaware. And they're more focused on all the scoffing and mocking and, you know, what these people are doing. Where I've been telling people, I don't even want to hear about them, you know. I block them where I don't see them. Unfortunately, other people had to see their comments, but it was a choice. You didn't have to read it, you know. And you didn't have to go in and read and watch their channels where all they're doing is causing people to fall away from the truth, you know. And that's what it says here, the surfeiting and drunkenness and cares of this life. You know, I'm sitting here trying to tell everybody the truth, and people are so busy trying to They want everything to be disproved. When the truth is right in front of you. You know, when I'm sitting there telling you those orbs that you can see them on the camera when they're moving around me like that, I'm telling you what they are. It's a spiritual battle. And the Holy Spirit that's in us protects us from these things, okay? And some of those are good angels. They're fighting for you. Remember, we all have angels around us too. But let me tell you something. If you love what's in this world, the Holy Spirit will depart. And so will those angels, okay? And he'll turn you over to the devil and these demons here. And that's what they want. When they're on here mocking and scoffing, what do you think they're doing? They're not comforting, are they? And then you want to give them attention and sit there and say that we should love them? That's just like saying you should love these homosexuals too. I am not here to tickle your ear. I'm here to tell you the truth. You know, these mockers and scoffers, where does it say in the Word of God that we should sit there and comfort them? Where does it say that we should be trying to pull them in to, you know, you want to focus on them? Or do you want to focus on your oil for your rapture to be departed out of here? Or do you want to focus on them that have the demons in them that are more concerned about your soul taking you to hell? Okay? Like I said, I'm not here to tickle ears. I'm here to tell you the truth. And I'm here to tell you what their plan is and what they want to do. Okay? Why do you think they're coming so hard against this channel? Because they know what I'm telling you is the truth. It's all the truth. I've got no reason to lie to you. None. I've been doing this for a long time, man. Very long time. Okay? Watch ye therefore and pray always that you may be accounted worthy to escape these things which shall come unto pass and to stand before the Son of Man. Okay? Listen, if you love what's an abomination to God, you're not going to like the results that you get from it. Okay, I've tried to warn people about that too. People saying, well, you're a little harsh on them. You know, I mean, you know, you need to tickle their ears a little more. You can draw more flies with honey. You know, well, that's the problem we got today. People have had their ears tickled too much and they don't know what the truth is anymore. Today, the truth is considered a lie and the lies are considered truth. Evil is called good and good is called evil. You know? Here we are in James chapter 4:4. Ye adulterers and adulteresses, know ye not that the friendship of the world is an enemy of God? Whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is an enemy of God. Okay, do you think that the scriptures saith in vain, the spirit that dwelleth in us lusteth to envy? But he giveth more grace. Wherefore he says, God resisteth the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble. Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Okay? But if you draw nigh to the devil, boy, all you're doing is helping destroy everybody else that's around here when we're trying to comfort one another. You know? You're not helping nobody. You know? And if you don't, can't see the difference in it. Listen, some people come in here and act like they're not of the devil, but let me tell you something. The moment that they're not comforting you and they're just out trying to prove and destroy more people, and if you're saying all these orbs are demons, be careful, because I'm going to tell you something. We got holy angels around us. You don't want to be calling them all demons. Remember, you got angels around you too. And if you want to call them demons, don't be surprised if they don't say, well, we don't need to be around here no more. You know, and the Holy Spirit wants to depart from you too. You know, because if you're calling him a demon, you better be very, very careful. This is a spiritual battle going on. I know what I'm saying. I've seen these things moving around me. I've also seen the angels. I know what's going on here. The Lord put it on me to see this. And then when I'm over here trying to explain what's going on, I got people trying to tell me about it. You know, then I'm like, aren't you not hearing what I'm saying? The Lord told me, the Lord revealed these things to me, and yet you're still questioning me on this? Doesn't make sense. And I'm not talking to each individual out there. I'm just talking to the ones out there, and they know who they are. Because they don't, the truth's not in them. If the truth is in them, they'd believe what I'm saying. They'd truly believe what I'm saying. Okay? You'd see that angel blowing that trumpet. At the end of the trumpet, what do you see? You see a white horse in a bathtub, which by the blood of Jesus Christ, we are redeemed. Okay? But I'm telling you right now, adulterers, cheaters, liars, perverted lifestyle, you think they're all saved by grace? No, they're not. You have to repent and follow Christ. Listen, when my wife divorced me, I have not had a single relationship, and I don't even look for one. I gave my heart to Jesus Christ at that moment. At that moment, I gave my heart to Christ. I have no desire to be in another relationship other than being with my Lord. That's the only relationship that I seek. I seek to be with Him. Okay? I do seek to comfort those that are going with me too. Those are my brothers and my sisters, okay? But there's so much ugly distraction, garbage out there. It's just, it's ugly. It's ugly. All right, remember what it says now, okay? About what's getting ready to happen. This is all at hand, man. This is getting ready to happen, man. I told you a while ago when I had that battle all night fighting a lot of these demons. The Lord helps me. So do the holy angels that are around me. And they're there to help you too. But you're going to have to overcome some of these things, okay? We do have to fight against these things. It's a spiritual battle. They're trying to seduce you. And you have to resist it, okay? It's not going to be a walk in the park. But the Lord knows we can handle it. And he wants us to get stronger. Because remember, man, where we're going is a beautiful place. And He doesn't want any trash in there. None. I seen where I was down here on the earth and I was looking up after I had that battle all night. It was in the morning just before I woke up. And I was looking up into the stars and man, it was like a great shaking here to where everything up there looked like it was moving. But actually it was right here where I was at. I believe there's going to be a great shaking coming here. Because you remember, the Lord said He'd leave that 99 to try to get that last one, okay? This is where you have to repent, man. And you can't be loving what's evil and an abomination to God. You just can't. You don't sit there and love what's evil. You don't. If you love what's evil, it's not going to be good. It's not going to be good at all. I'm focusing now more on this channel and those that... are on this channel. I'm not looking to try to rebuke anybody out there that's on all these other channels. I only focus on those that are with me right here. It's not my job to go on to all these other channels and try to tell people what to do or how to do it. If the Holy Spirit's with you, you should know and feel what's right and what's wrong. And if you got friends out there, you know, it's up to you guys to reach out to the people that you know to get them the truth, okay? I'm not going on other people's channels and stirring up anything because everybody's going to follow the path that they're on. And I've been doing this for several years. And I'm going to tell you, I am tired. I'm real tired. You know, I've been doing this for quite a while. It's not my job to go out there and try to stir other people's channels up. Or to rebuke other people. There's too many of them out there. But it is important that I tell you guys the truth here, okay? Which is this. You know, we're getting ready to go home, okay? And we don't want to be here for what's getting ready to happen, okay? That great shaking that I've seen happening... Listen to this, Titus 11 through 15 on chapter 2. For the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world, which we're not seeing that too much, are we? Looking for that blessed hope and that glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. These things speak and exhort and rebuke with all authority. Let no man despise thee. Okay. James chapter 4:4. Ye adulterers and adulteresses, know ye not that the friendship of the world is an enemy with God? Whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is an enemy of God. Okay? Humble yourselves in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up. Be afflicted and mourn and weep, and let your laughter be turned into mourning and your joy into heaviness. That's why you guys never see me making comments going, LOL, like it's, I'm laughing out loud and stuff like that. See, I've also heard LOL stands for love of Lucifer. See, there's a lot of things out there that a lot of these people are doing. Let me ask you something. We, knowing that this is the end, what's so funny? Really, tell me, what is so funny about this end time? A lot of people getting ready to go to hell and all that. What is so funny about it? I don't find anything funny about it. Most of my family's in reprobated minds right now. They don't see what's coming. You know, I don't find anything humorous here. I haven't found anything humorous for quite a while. That's why I'm living in my truck, you know. I'm trying to comfort you guys, get you ready. I'm looking forward to that blessed hope of the Lord coming, you know, where I can one day smile and feel that joy that I want to feel. But right now, no, there's no great joy here. I mean, I'm not enjoying this. There's no nothing here that I'm enjoying. You know, I mean, when you're truly living in, what does it say here? Affliction. When you're truly, now I could have been living like the devil. I had a lot of high paying job offers. You know, a lot of these people, scoffers, mockers will tell you, oh, he could have been making $120,000 a year, $60,000 a year working for his football coach. Devil offered him. Oh, they didn't say the devil. They just said I had a lot of good job offers I turned down. But that was the devil wanting me to work with him to be worldly. But see, then I wouldn't be here warning anybody, would I? Instead, I'd have been living like the devil, wanting, you know, getting that nice sports car and living the dream life, you know. But you guys just heard what I read. A friend of the world. He's not a friend of God. You know what I mean? 1 John, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. All right, that's chapter 2, 1 John 15. Here's 16 on down. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life, is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof. But he that does the will of God abideth forever. Little children, see, we will be like little children when we get into the kingdom of heaven. I've told you I had that feeling. Man, I've had a lot of dreams of good things, what's getting ready to happen. And it's all at hand. The Lord has revealed certain things to some people, quite a few. But sadly, there's so many distractions and deceptions out there. It's hard to separate them all. It's really hard to separate them all. There's so many liars and deceivers out there. It's not even funny. You know, I'm grateful that the Lord gave me this. I took it in 77 when I was 17. But man, I didn't get it until 2014, but I'm grateful that he gave this to me. You know how I'm going to provide in that description box about those orbs flying around? Now you look at that spirit above my head. Now when they're moving, I mean moving, modocking fast, that's what they look like, little orbs, fast. He blew up a little bigger right here for this photo. That's what they do. They can do anything they want to do. They can even appear like a human being in front of you, just like that. I met them already, a couple of them. several times. And I've also seen demons, you know. And there's more wicked things than you want to even know. I've seen things. That's why I told you to pray over your food, man. I'm not just saying it to be talking. I mean, pray over everything. Your water, your food, everything, man. Be forever, like the Word of God says, man. And don't focus on reading the scoffers and mockers, man. Not just this channel, but all the channels, man. Avoid them. If it's not comforting anybody, don't read it. Stay away from it. Okay? But if people are telling you to love something in this world, you heard what I said. It says clearly, a friend of the world is not a friend of God's. Okay? And if you love what's evil, homosexual lifestyle, people tell you, oh, well, God loves them. I'm telling you, and you got love for what's an abomination to God in your heart, you better not have that love of what's evil in your heart. Because the Holy Spirit's not going to dwell where you got the wrong love. Okay? You can't love what's filthy. Okay? We have to look for what's righteous in God's eyes. Okay? And you know it, but you don't have to hate them either. Okay? You don't have to ridicule them or nothing, you know? If anything, you pray and say, you know, hey, is it really worth it? Is it really worth it? The Word of God says, you know, repent and to follow Him. That's what I did, man. When I went through my divorce, my wife divorced me. You guys heard about it, that police officer, everything. He ended up getting killed, you know, my gosh. 3 months after I signed my divorce, and I never hated him. That was the first night I had a dream about Obama, too, when I seen him on the news getting killed. Then Obama was saying that I owed him. I said, I don't owe you nothing, man. I said, how could you turn your back on the Lord? You know, and he had that weird-looking smile on his face, you know. But anyhow, look. I don't want this to be a real long video. Listen, here it says, but these things I have written unto you concerning them that seduce you. But the anointing which ye have received of him abideth in you. Okay? The Holy Spirit, okay, abideth in you. Please be careful with that, okay? Please. That's what they're after. They want to get that Holy Spirit out of you, man. And I don't want that to happen. Check out the description box, and you're going to see the spiritual battle. It starts at about 4:15, 4:30, somewhere around there. You'll see those little orbs or whatever going around. There's a battle going on. You'll see cups going in me, coming out of me. And it's happening with all of us, okay? It's happening a lot with me because I was chosen, okay? There's a big battle going on over here, okay? But like I said, as long as you're with the Holy Spirit, you got nothing to worry about, okay? I mean, nothing. But some of us are chosen, you know? So I'm going to have more coming against me because of my message I'm trying to get to you. And that's why I am where I am, you know what I mean? It's not a picnic, man. It's not a picnic. I long for this to be over, man. I'm super tired. But remember, check out the description box. Please read it or watch it. And that way you'll have a better understanding of what's going on. I had one lady that said they're all demons. Please be careful what you say there because you don't want to mock the Holy Spirit either. Okay? They're not all demons, okay? When we leave this flesh and blood, you're going to have a spirit too. And, you know, hopefully it won't be a demonic spirit. It'll be a heavenly spirit, okay? Because there is going to be a big separation going on. Many are going to hell, and few are going to make it to the kingdom of heaven, okay? So don't mock the Holy Spirit. Don't mock the angels, okay? Because some of them are here fighting for you now. You just can't see it, okay? But you can't love what's an abomination to God. You have to love what's right. But at the same time, you don't hate. And that's why I said, I don't want nothing to do with any of this live rebuking, like they're going to do something to somebody and belittle them and whatever. I'm not going to be a part of that. I ain't a part of that, okay? Jesus Christ would ask yourself, would he be out there doing it? No, he wouldn't. He'd just be telling you the truth, and you'll either receive it, and you'll move forward and follow him, because we're all going either one direction or the other. So be careful where you're following, okay? God bless each and every one of yous, and please see the description box, okay? Love yous.